An intellectually disabled Dapto woman who poured boiling water over her abusive partner has been found not guilty of murder, but guilty of manslaughter. After years of volatile cohabitation, Pearl Marie Wilson, 63, likely doused 46-year-old Jason Shepstow in scalding water multiple times in the hours leading to his February 12, 2013 death. Afterwards, having seen him vomit up blood and other stuff, she helped him onto a dry mattress, cleaned up, lay down beside him and cuddled him and went to sleep with him. The Crown pointed to these tender acts as signs of Wilson's guilt, clues she understood the seriousness of Mr. Shepstow's situation. But a judge accepted expert evidence this was part of a cycle of behavior, aggression, regret, reconciliation, sleep, typical to people in abusive relationships. Wilson was declared medically unfit for a trial by jury and faced a special hearing in the New South Wales Supreme Court before Judge Monica Schmidt, who delivered her verdict on Wednesday. The judge considered the differing accounts Wilson provided to police and doctors in 2013, 2014 and 2015. At one point, for instance, she attributed the water throwing to Mr. Shepstow having grabbed her arm while she made tea. Another time she said she lashed out because he grabbed her around the throat and she thought I was going to die at the time. He's done it before, I can't breathe when he puts his hands round my throat or the pillow over me. The judge found the inconsistencies could have been the result of her intellectual disability, dementia and PTSD. Also, it was possible all three accounts were true, since Mr. Shepstow had been repeatedly doused. Mr. Shepstow had cirrhosis of the liver so severe it could have killed him at any time. But ultimately it was hypovolemic shock that killed him, the result of there not being enough blood in his vessels to carry oxygen to his lungs and brain, the combined effect of his bruising and burns. Wilson directed police to a metal pole, about 2 kilograms heavy and 57 cm long, and admitted to having hit Mr. Shepstow with it on the legs and bones. The court heard details of Wilson's nightmarish childhood. She suffered abuse throughout, was fostered then placed in an orphanage and had never been able to learn to read or write. She fell within the bottom 1% of the population for intellectual functioning and had an IQ of just 63. Mr. Shepstow had sclerosis of the liver so severe it could have killed him at any time. But ultimately it was hypovolemic shock that killed him, the result of there not being enough blood in his vessels to carry oxygen to his lungs and brain, the combined effect of his bruising and burns. His lifeless body was found naked under a blanket, covered in blisters. Burns covered 20% of his body and he had 65 blunt force injuries. But the judge found his liver disease had made him vulnerable to such bruises. Just as not all of Wilson's bruises could be attributed to him, the same was true in reverse. The judge found pouring more near boiling water on Mr. Shepstow would ultimately have caused him to fall to the ground, unable to get to a cold shower. What Ms. Wilson then did was, undoubtedly, unreasonable and excessive, notwithstanding Mr. Shepstow's tendency, his conduct to that point that night and even the nature of their past relationship, Judge Schmidt said.